Hi guys, Sean Tony here, and here's my long awaited let's play of a certain game that I've actually been trying to let's play for a while now. I finally can do it, sorry for the wait. And it is Kingdom Hearts Birthplace League, the first ever game in the Kingdom Hearts timeline. I want to do it chronologically, and I'm going to show off all three characters. Well, I mean, I have to, and I want to anyway, so, here we go. I'm gonna start my let's play before I sleep now. If you ever knew, some of my friends helped this, like, Daryl, Nerdinator, and, Lazy Munchlax. I was trying to do with my sleep. I was gonna first do with PlayStation portable in my hands, but I'm just saying that that would get too messy. I mean, I won't be able to adjust it. Again. Yeah, sorry if the screen is a bit small, but this is small how ESP games actually sound, but just because I don't really care, because, well, I've been looking this for a while. I've been looking for one of these for a while now, and like I said, my Sonic 502 video, I'm actually glad that I found one. And that is the intro for Birthplace Sleep, and let's start this game off. You can see that there was file vintage here, but should be twice, I believe. So I'm gonna start on power mode. Choose a proud mode. And well, I'm gonna show off the basic tutorials off here. I'm playing this game in proud mode, and I can also say that there's gonna be a cutscene. Oh, you guys already seen the intro. I'm just saying this, this is clipping, so I'll let you guys watch that.
This world is just too small. See, an empty world, like a prison. I imagine you will be right at home.
Who's there?
I guess it's time to choose the character. That was it, guys. I just wanted to
open the door.
Thank you. I mean, we're already 10 minutes in. And guys, if...
Meteor shower.
And the first move in this game, wind up departure.
I can't see much from here.
I'm gonna show off this control, even though I played this game a lot. I'm just gonna show them off anyway.
Wait, what am I messing around here for? I'm gonna miss the meteor shower.
Well, before I can do that, I'm just gonna show up, where the other treasure chests are, and, like you can see, well, it's got kind of looks like rocks as you play the other Kingdom Hearts games, but, I'll just say it, that you'll find out what his name is later in, this part, so yeah.
Why does this seem so familiar? Give me a break, Aqua. Then, you hopeless sleepyhead. You know, you should have at least brought a blanket. But did I dream that place up? It really felt like I'd been there before, looking up at the stars. Except you've always lived here with us. Yeah. I know. Hey, Aqua.
Hmm?
You ever wonder what stars are? Where light comes from?
Hmm. Well, they say
that every star up there is another world.
Huh? Oh. Terra.
Yep. Hard to believe there are so many worlds out there besides our own. The light is their hearts. And it's shining down on us like a million lanterns.
What? I don't get it.
Well, in other words, they're just like you, Ben.
What does that mean?
You'll find out someday, I'm sure.
I want to know now.
You're too young to know now.
Quit treating me like a kid.
Hey, what are you laughing at?
I can't help it. You two would make the weirdest brothers.
Huh?
Yeah. Terra, you and I have our mark of mastery, Sam Small. I made us good luck charms.
Wow.
Here.
I get one, too?
Of course. One for each of us.
Yeah.
Somewhere out there, there's this tree with star-shaped fruit. And the fruit represents an unbreakable connection. So as long as you and your friends carry good luck charm shaped like it, nothing can ever drive you apart. You will always find your way back to each other. Technically, I think you're supposed to make them with seashells. But I did the best with what I had.
Boy, sometimes you are such a girl.
Hey, what do you mean sometimes?
So this isn't a real good luck charm?
Well, that's yet to be seen. But I did work a little magic on it.
Really? What?
An unbreakable connection.
Okay, will you find her one of these three good luck charms Aqua made for herself and her friends the day before the Micro Mastery exam? And the Waypoint allows you to use the dimension link with friends and borrow the power. You will meet lots of characters throughout the story that you can be linked with. Which is true, I'll probably might show those off in another video or later on. And we're almost 27 minutes in, huh?
Well, tomorrow's the exam. Anybody want to spar?
I can take you.
Fine if you're fighting one-on-one, but you need to know how to handle a crowd, too.
Okay, let's wrap this up. Oh, shoot. Well, the guy in the burn is Terra. The person that looks like Roxas is Ventus, and the girl with the blue hair is Aqua, so I'm going to choose the character for this fight. I'm going to choose Terra. And basically that will probably give away this one that I'm doing. So yeah. So I gotta face Aqua.
Master said, power is born within the heart. When the time is right, you just need to look inside yourself, and you'll find it there.
You're troubled. Okay, this is basically... old glory gaming telling us that our world.
Oh, we don't want to lose track of stuff that's happened.
Oh, basically, if you guys have, like, never played the Kingdom Hearts series, there are probably say people that you kind of know what that green circle thing is. And, well, it's a save point.
Together. Always.
That would be the last night we ever spent beneath the same stars.
Mickey, I cannot shake the feeling something terrible is about to transpire.
Well, like you can see, this is Mickey's game too. Well, like I said before, I wanted to do the timeline because, you know, if you guys can play them in order, it would be better to try the timeline. I mean, try like the way that it was supposed to be. So basically, obviously, the first game is the second game of the timeline. In this game, you choose one character at a time and complete his or her story from start to finish. Each character visits different places and meets different people, and only by finishing all three stories, they uncover this tale's deeper truth. Terra is a disquieted young man who feels compelled to find greater strength. He relies on brute force in combat. Ventus, an ongoing and inquisitive boy who holds his Keyblade backhand. Quick attacks are his forte. And Aqua, a kind young woman whose sense of right and wrong never wavers. She is nimble and a gifted mage. And, well, of all the stories that I played, Terra is, well, the one that I had the most trouble on. Basically, the final boss speaks for itself, so I just want to get Terra out of the way. So yeah, I'm gonna be Terra. Like I said earlier in the part, like that never gave it away.
mark of mastery. Not one, but two of the Keyblades chosen stand here as candidates. This is neither a competition nor a battle for supremacy. Not a test of wills, but a test of heart. Both of you may prevail, or neither. But I am sure our guest, Master Sayador, did not travel all this way to see our youngest prospects in years fall short of the mark. I trust you are ready.
Yes.
Then let the examination begin.
Just as hard as us.
Yeah. Stay sharp, Pat.
Well, we are almost 33 minutes in. I can probably say, and my PSP battery life is only at 3, so I better charge that and probably record some more. I'm probably say this is the only because I might record and probably record later on today. Using deck commands, you'll sometimes change combat styles. These command styles you get depends on how many and which deck commands you use.
That was unexpected. But one must keep a still heart even in the most trying of circumstances. It was an excellent test, one I chose to let unfold. Which brings us to your next trial. Now, Terra and Aqua, the two of you will face each other in combat. Remember, there are no winners, only truths. For when equal powers clash, their nature is revealed. Begin. have deliberated and reached a decision. Terra, Aqua, you both performed commendably. However, only Aqua has shown the mark of mastery. Terra, you failed to keep the darkness within you sufficiently in check. But there is always next time. That is all. Aqua, as our newest Keyblade Master, you are entitled to certain knowledge. Please wait here for further instruction.
Hey.
Terra, I'm sorry.
The darkness, where did it come from? What do you make of Ventus?
He ain't gonna cut it. Somebody's gotta break that loser in.
Not here, you won't. I have to keep up appearances.
I know that. He just needs a little incentive to leave home.
Sorry. But I need some time alone.
That kind of sucks. Well,
there's darkness within me. So what does that matter? I know I'm strong enough to hold it back.
Yes. You are indeed strong. The darkness has nothing to fear.
Master Xehanort.
And yet, how frustrating that Ericus refutes its power. Why, you could train with him forever, and still, you would never be a master in his eyes.
But why? Help me understand, Master Xehanort. What is it that I failed to learn?
You're fine as you are. Darkness cannot be destroyed. It can only be channeled.
Yes. Thank you, Master.
Okay, well, it's a few minutes since I'm probably at the 40-minute mark.
What happened?
I don't know. Why isn't Ven here?
Very well, then. I will send my pupils to investigate. Yes, I understand. Farewell. That was my dear old friend Yen Sid. As you know, he is master no more, but he still keeps a close eye on the tides of light and darkness. His counsel serves as signposts on the road we wielders of the Keyblade must walk. All the more reason then for concern, for he tells me the princesses of heart are in danger, not only from the forces of darkness, which you may assume, but also from a new threat, one that feeds on negativity. Fledgling emotions that have taken monster form, Yen Sid calls them the Unversed. As wielders of the Keyblade, you are tasked with striking down any who would upset the balance of light and darkness. The Unversed are no exception. I tried to pass this news on to Master Xehanort, but my repeated attempts to reach him have failed. I doubt there is any connection in it. This all troubles me.
Master Xehanort is gone?
So here we are, I need you two to get this situation under control. Eliminate the Unversed and find Master Xehanort. I have unlocked the lanes between. You may use these forbidden pathways to travel between this world and countless others. The darkness looms closer than usual within these spaces, but your armor will protect you. Lastly, remember that order must be kept. You cannot tell anyone there are other worlds. Now go and fulfill your duty.
Yes, Master.
Terra, consider this an opportunity, a second chance for you to change my mind.
What?
You must know, I care for you like my own son. If I could have my way, I would name you master in a second. But how can I, when you are so obsessed with power? Terra, you mustn't be afraid of losing. Fear leads to obsession with power, and obsession beckons the darkness. You must never forget.
Thank you, Master. I swear, I will not fail you again.
Okay, well, if you guys want to find the nearest checkpoint, and I'm almost 43 minutes in, so I'm probably say I want to end this video quick and see how much. Okay, go to Silvuvar's.
Terra!
It's okay.
Okay, so I forged the delinquent dentist. Okay, basically it's telling us how to use the delink, so I'm gonna show that off in another video, and it's show that we can get more items, so we can power them, so we can get them more powerful. So, I'm just saying this, I finally got that I can let's play this game, and, I'll end the video off, whoa, 39 minutes in, and, in the next part, well, I'm just gonna save. We are going to go to the first world besides the Land of Departure in Chinatown, Maine. So, see you guys then.